In this video, I will be showing you my process for going from a blank outline to a finished image with rendering, lighting, and post-processing effects. Starting off with every image, I create a new layer set to multiply to add in some gradients. This starts the lighting process and makes it easier for me to know where to place the shadows and highlights later on. Instead of using a single multiply layer, you can use several different layers for each different surface that you're rendering. This would allow you greater control over each shadow color, but at the cost of time and speed. After all the gradients are in place, I move on to the hard edges. I create a new layer set to multiply and use the same color I had selected for the gradient section. Both the hard edges layer and the gradients layer are clipped to the base colors layer below. This helps speed things up as the base layer now acts as a mask to the rest of the layers that are clipped. To select the different areas for rendering, I use the magic wand tool and set the selection option to select from reference layers and set the outline as a reference layer. I continue this process until all the surfaces are rendered with the hard edges for the shadows. In order to keep track of the rendering while making sure everything is lit correctly, I like to add a correction layer above my base colors to change them to white as it allows me to render in monochrome. This helps reduce the chance of being distracted by the color of each surface and instead focus on the value changes from the light source. Once the shadows are rendered, I move on to coloring the eyes. I start with the white parts of the eyes, add some shadowing, and then move on to the iris section. Begin the highlight section with a single glow dodge layer. I use a soft textured brush with opacity control as it gives me the effect that I'm going for. Just like in the shadow section, the highlight layer is clipped to the layers below it and all selections are done with the magic wand tool. After the main highlights are in place, I create a new glow dodge layer for bounce lighting and ambient lighting. Since the highlights were warm colors, I use a blue light for the bounce and ambient lighting. With the main light source being in the top right corner of the image, I place the new light source to the left of the image to balance things out. Now that the majority of the lighting and shadows are finished, I go back in and render out some of the finer details. It is also at this point where I go back and tweak some of the layer settings in case there are some shadows that are too dark or highlights that are too bright. With major rendering processes finished for the character, I go in and begin rendering the background. The process I use for backgrounds is similar to character rendering. I start with the soft shadows, render out the hard edges, and go back in with highlights and additional light sources. For all of the background painting, I use the soft, textured brush with opacity control that I use for the highlights section of the character render. The background is made of several glow dodge layers with highlights and multiply layers for the shadows. Several layers are used to create the lighting effect, and they're all layered on top of each other in various different ways. Once the background is complete, I go back into the character and start rendering out the different textures, materials, and clothing patterns. tie the background and character together, I add in some foreground elements. For this image, I use a foreground layer to add in a dust effect and additional lighting from the top right light source. After all the rendering and post-processing is complete, all that's left to do is add a noise pattern over top the entire image to correct the smooth look that usually accompanies a digital painting, and finally add the watermark to the bottom left corner of the image.